Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hopefully you guys are doing well. Today I'm coming at you guys with a small makeup show haul. As you guys know, I went to the makeup show here in Orlando, Florida, and I absolutely loved it. I enjoyed it. I met so many celebrity MUAs. I had a blast, and I went with my friend Trina. She's an MUA in Tallahassee, Florida. Hey girl, if you're watching, we had so much fun. Like, it was just ridiculous how much fun we had. We went to the show, we went out for dinner, spent time in her hotel room. It was just amazing. And yes, I took my son. My son was like everything at the makeup show. Every woman wanted to eat him up. It was ridiculous, and he loved it too. So enough of me rambling, let's go ahead and get into the haul. Okay, so the first place I stopped was the OCC counter. And by the way, I didn't have a strategy on where I wanted to stop first. I just was happy to be in the presence of all the makeup. So I went a little, you know, crazy. I was swatching a little bit of everything, but I didn't purchase everything that I wanted. But we're gonna leave that alone. But the first place that I did stop was OCC, in search of some lip tars and just to see what they had new on the market. Now there, I only purchased one thing, but I will say I do absolutely love what I purchased. I have something like it, but I'm happy with it. And what I got was the OCC Matte Lip Tar in Sebastian. And it's like a gray toned. It's very, very beautiful. This will be so bomb with a smoky eye. Oh my gosh, a navy smoky eye at that. I would absolutely love this. Now, you guys should know what a lip tar is. It's pretty much a stained lip color. I guess some people would call it stained lipstick, whatever you want to call it. But it goes on very satiny, and then it dries to a matte. So I absolutely love these. I love keeping these in my kit, especially for brides. I love these. I just do. And they don't dry your lips out, but you do need to keep your lips moisturized or moisturize them before applying a product like this. But I do love this, and I'll show you a swatch. And if you guys know lip tars, a little goes a long way. So that was a lot. But that is what it looks like. It's absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous color. We don't have a Nigel's Beauty Emporium here in Orlando. Not that I know of, at least. I'm new here. But I did want to stop and pick up some lashes, and their lashes were 7 for $10, which was awesome. So I picked up a couple pairs of lashes, some to keep in my kit and some for myself. So I'm actually wearing a pair of lashes that I bought from them, and these are the 747m's, and this is what it looks like. These are the 747m's. I also picked up the Wispies, a pair of Demi Wispies, two number 15s, another pair of 747m's that I'm wearing right now. My baby just woke up. Hold on 1 second. I have my son in my lap right now. Say hi. Say hi. Yeah, he just woke up from a nap. So I'm gonna keep on moving with him in my lap, my precious little man. Okay, so the next thing that I purchased, well, actually, I didn't even purchase this. This was a gift to Akari, because he looked bored in his stroller. So the man from the company actually gifted this to Akari, and it is a Five Wells color palette, and mommy will get a lot of use out of this. He loved it. He was just chewing on the package. Yeah, you loved it. Yeah, he loved it. He was chewing on the package and all that. Of course he loved it. But this is what it looks like. You just put your concealers or your lipsticks or whatever you like in these little sections, and that's all you do. And it's nice and convenient for for your kit. So yeah, I think I'll just melt some of my concealers or my lipsticks. Yeah, Papa. Melt some of my concealers or my lipsticks and apply this in my kit. The next place that I went was Crown Brush. Everyone knows Crown Brush has the most affordable and very, very good brushes. I didn't go ham like I wanted to. Of course, I was on a budget, like I was not playing. I was staying to my budget and I stuck to it. But I did pick up a couple brushes that I needed for myself. And yeah, let me just go ahead and show you. These are the brushes that I picked up, and excuse them, they are dirty. I used it for this face today. And this tutorial will probably be up before or after, not sure, but you'll see how I achieved this look. But these are the brushes that I picked up. The first brush that I picked up is this duo ended brush. It is a brow brush, has a brow, dense brow brush right there in a spoolie at the end, and I believe this brush was only $2. The next brush that I picked up was this blending brush right here. It's just a crease brush, blending brush. I love this. It's dense enough to pick up the color, but it's light enough to fluff the color and blend the color out. So love this, had to get it. I believe it was only like $3. Next, I got this tapered crease brush, and I use it for the outer part right here, and I absolutely love this brush. This was only $2. Next brush that I picked up is this very small, like mini smudger brush, and I use this for the under eye. This is what I use to pack on that color and just smudge it out underneath the eyes. And I also use this brush for when I just want to apply a little bit of mascara and the mascara kind of smudges a little bit. I take this brush and just run it underneath the lash line, and it just blends it out like a dream. I absolutely love this brush as well. This brush, I believe, was $2. The next brush that I got is this duo fiber blender brush, and I use this for my highlighter on my cheekbones. Yeah, not much to say about it just yet, but it does the job. It applies my highlighter like I need it to. So yeah, it does the job. It was like $4, $5. So yeah. The next brush that I picked up is this fan brush, mascara fan brush. I'm not sure if you can see it. There we go. It's a mascara fan brush. But I was in a keynote segment with Rennie Vasquez, and he showed us a technique with this brush, so I do want to try his technique, see how I like it. So yeah, I had to pick it up. It was only like $2. And the next brush that I picked up was this brush right here, which is a lip brush. You can never go wrong, and you can never have too many lip brushes. So this one is perfect. It's light enough, fluffy enough. I don't really like those super dense lip brushes. It smears the lipstick, and I'm not a fan of that. I like when they're nice and fluffy but flat, that way it blends out that lip liner and also carries that lipstick in and just lays it really smooth. I absolutely love this, and this was $2. So that's all I got from Crown Brush. Those brushes were all, that was all I saw that I absolutely needed at the moment, and of course it was packed, so ain't nobody got time for that. The next and final place that I stopped was Magnolia Makeup. I had to go support the girls. They're from Louisiana, and their accents are so rich, so thick, is ridiculous, and I love hearing people with those thick, rich accents. It's just I just love it. So I had to go stop and support the girls. I've been hearing so much about them on social media and YouTube. So of course I had to go by and pick up just a couple products. The product that I picked up first is this glitter. This glitter right here, and I believe this is called Purple Halo or Purple Flame. I believe it's called Purple Flame. It is a very rich purple with iridescence. Let me zoom in for you. And this is what it looks like. I'm not sure if you can see. It just has a lot of iridescence in it, and I'll be doing a tutorial with this soon, so don't worry. So yeah, I picked that up because it was only $5 when I picked it up. On the site it's $12, but yeah, and I've been eyeing that color for I don't know how long, so I wanted to pick that up. And I also picked up this, I think it's called a velour gloss. I'm not sure, don't quote me on it, but you go to their websites and they'll have all the colors, and the color that I picked up is midnight violet. My gosh, oh my gosh, you guys have no clue how much I love this. This is like my life in a tube right now, like rich deep purpley blue, like eggplanty color. And it stays on like I don't know how. Like, I don't know how this stays on. Like, it's amazing, you guys. I'm gonna swatch it right now. Oh my gosh. Can you guys see that? Like, can you see the rich matte goodness of this color? And oh my gosh, it is just I need a moment real fast. Yeah, so that lip color is everything, and I believe they run for $15. I purchased mine for $10. Can't beat that, love it. And it is comparable to those lime crime velveteens, I want to say, and also the Dose of Color liquid lip colors. Matte lip stain, it goes on so satiny smooth, and it dries to a matte finish, and it's there, like it stays on. And I also ombre this. I applied this color, then I put this color on the center of my lip, and it looked so good, so gorgeous. I can't even talk, gorgeous. I love this. Go cop one, tell them I sent you. I See You Gorgeous Midnight Violet by Magnolia Makeup. Okay guys, so that is it for the haul today. That's all I purchased. I told you guys I'm balling on the budget. Baby boy, what are you doing? Say hey. I guess not, but I will be going back next year, and hopefully you guys will see me there. So yeah, that's it. Until next time, I see you gorgeous. Bye.